Good morning friends. Today we are going to discuss the new topic of pharmacokinetics. Myself, Mr. Hungarekar SR, Assistant Professor from Shivalingeshwar College of Pharmacy, Almala, Taluka Osa, District Latur, from Maharashtra. Please subscribe our YouTube channel, SUP.academics. So, pharmacokinetics is nothing but this is the study of absorption, distribution, metabolism and excretion. In this chapter, we have to discuss the different parameters related to the pharmacokinetics. The basics involved in this, we have to discuss in this chapter. So, in this chapter, we have to discuss the different parameters such as the duration of drug therapy, ranges from a single dose of drug, from acute conditions of drugs taken lifelong for a chronic condition. The dosage regimen we have to discuss here, the frequency of administration of a drug from a particular dose. Next one, that is we have to discuss clinical pharmacokinetics, that is nothing but the study of pharmacokinetic principles in a individual patient to treat this disease is called as the clinical pharmacokinetics. Next one, we have to discuss the population pharmacokinetics, that is nothing but study of pharmacokinetic parameter into the different population, that is the population pharmacokinetics. Toxicokinetics is there, this means it is the application of this pharmacokinetic principle, whether the drug gives a toxic response or therapeutic response, we have to discuss here. Next, in this basics of this chapter, we have to discuss in this, that is the plasma concentration time profile after administration of a dose to the patient. Means here, when we are administering a specific dose of drug, this dose, it will goes into systemic circulation, and the dose of this drug, it will goes into our body parts. That means it will goes into the systemic circulation in the form of a blood plasma. Blood plasma is the major part where the drug directly goes into that systemic circulation. Through this, it will be circulated inside the different body parts. This is the graphical representation. This is a profile that is called the plasma concentration time profile. Means on x-axis there is a time, and on y-axis there is a plasma drug concentration is there. If you plot this graph, if you see this graph, in this graph they had given the different parameters. There are the basic two parameters, pharmacokinetic parameter and pharmacodynamic parameters is there. They had given in this, see in this graph, this graph is divided into the two portions. First one is the absorption phase, second one is the post absorption phase. In this phase, absorption phase is there where the route of drug administration started at the zero point, then the onset of action it will be started, then it will give the PC max, that means peak plasma concentration of a drug. After that it will give the termination of action, which is called as the post absorption phase, and lastly the elimination phase is there. If you study in this curve, that there are the two categories. First one is the pharmacokinetic category, second one is the pharmacodynamic parameter. In case of this pharmacokinetic parameter, it is included or it is divided into the three parts, three parameters. First one is the peak plasma drug concentration, in you can say that Cmax. Second one, time of peak concentration, Tmax. Third one, area under curve. The peak plasma concentration, it is nothing but it is expressed in mcg per ml. It gives the rate of drug absorption, which is depend upon the different parameters such as dose of drug administered, rate of absorption, as well as the rate of elimination. Means it will give the highest concentration of a drug present inside the body parts, that is the peak plasma concentration expressed in mcg per ml. Time of peak concentration. It is the time which is expressed at the peak plasma concentration is called as the time of peak concentration or Tmax. It is expressed in hours. This time of peak concentration, it will depends upon the onset time and onset of action. When we are taking the drug, after that the first stage where the onset of action will be started, where the onset of time will be started, based upon that Cmax will be, as well as Cmax and Tmax will be determined. The third important pharmacodynamic kinetic parameter is that is the area under curve. It means it is the maximum area covered by the drug, that is the area under curve. It is expressed in mcg per ml and hours. It gives the extent of drug absorption. This parameter is majorly important in the studying of the bioavailability of a drug in a specific dosage form. Second important parameter, that is the pharmacodynamic parameter. This pharmacodynamic parameter is divided into the 7 important parameters. The first one, maximum effective concentration, minimum minimum effective concentration, maximum safe concentration, onset of action, onset of time, duration of action, intensity of action, therapeutic range and therapeutic index. Minimum effective concentration is the concentration where the drugs will start a minimum effect of dose, that is the minimum effective concentration. Maximum safe concentration is nothing but the stage at which the drugs will give the maximum safe concentration. After that, it will give the toxic response. Onset of action is nothing but this is the stage or this is the condition at which the drugs gives a first pharmacological response, that is the onset of action. Onset of time is nothing but this is the time at which the drugs gives first onset of action, is called the onset of time. Duration of action, it is the action where the drugs gives a specific duration to produce a specific pharmacological action. Intensity of action, maximum drug concentration present inside the body parts to give the peak plasma concentration, that is called as the intensity of action. Therapeutic range, this is the range which comes under the minimum safe effective concentration and maximum safe concentration, that is called as the therapeutic range. Therapeutic index, the ratio of maximum safe concentration to minimum safe effective concentration is called as the therapeutic index. Next important parameter after this plasma concentration time profile, we have to discuss the order of reaction. This is the reaction in which the concentration of drug influence the rate of reaction or a process, is called as the order of reaction. Generally, if you discuss for a reaction, dc by dt is equal to minus k into c raised to n, where k is equal to rate constant, n is equal to order of reaction, and this n is nothing but order of reaction. This order of reaction may be zero order kinetics, may be first order kinetic. Based upon this order of reaction, it is of three types: zero order kinetics, first order kinetics, mixed order kinetics. The zero order is nothing but which is not depend upon the concentration, first order which is a depend upon the concentration, mixed order is nothing but this is the concentration it dependent, means it is a mixture of first order as well as the zero order kinetics. Now we will discuss the zero order kinetics. It is also called as the constant rate process. This is the process in which the rate of a drug is constant. Therefore, this is called as the zero order kinetics, which is expressed in this formula. dc by dt is equal to minus k 0 into c 0, where k 0 is the zero order rate constant expressed in mg per minute. After this rearrangement, we have to use this here mathematical formulation, mathematical calculation. And in this graph, they had given the plot of time versus dc by dt. It will give the steady state and drug release, and they had given the slope, that is minus k0. Therefore, based upon that, the zero order kinetics equation is equal to log c is equal to c0 minus kt, and zero order half life is t half is equal to c0 divided by 2k0. The examples of zero order kinetics is controlled drug delivery system, that is implants, osmotic pumps, administration of a drug by a constant rate IV infusion. Thank you.